So what does every real estate YouTube channel out there have in common? Is it A, they talk about first-time homebuyer mistakes, B, how to invest in real estate, or C, the epic recession, bubble, foreclosure, California's way too expensive flood of 2021? If you guess C, you are 100% correct, but in this video, I'm gonna share why this could very well be 100% incorrect. And despite the fake news, California and Los Angeles, historically speaking, are a lot more affordable than you think. Let's talk about it coming up. So let's build a case. One, the median price for a single family home in California is currently around $800,000, to which people are like, what? That is ridiculous. These prices are unprecedented. And it's like, yeah, I would hope so. That's kind of the point of any investment, that prices become unprecedented over time. I mean, that's why people invest in California, Los Angeles, and real estate in general. Prices tend to go up. But like, the point is, the current median price for a house in California is about $800,000. Now, California at its height 15 years ago in 2007, when we actually had a bubble right before the recession, the California median price hit a high of $590,000, to which people are like, yeah, exactly. We're now way past that number, and that's why we're in a bubble and the market is gonna crash. Not necessarily. I mean, once you account for inflation using the consumer price index, in today's money, that $590,000 property actually cost $780,000, a $20,000 difference from where we're at now. So not a big difference. But wait, that's not all. Interest rates today on a 30-year fixed mortgage are about 3%. In 2007, they were around 6%, twice as much as they are today. So once we account for inflation, interest rates, not even accounting for economic growth or wage increases in the past 15 years, California real estate has yet to hit the heights of 2007. 15 years ago. So all things considered, it's actually cheaper or more affordable to buy a house in California today than it was 15 years ago. And a shameless interruption to let you know that if you enjoy this video, it would mean a lot if you hit like or subscribe. And sorry about that, but let's not stop here. Let's keep digging. If you bought a medium price house 15 years ago for $590,000, 20% down with an interest rate of 6%, your total interest paid over the life of the loan would be about $550,000. Now, if you buy a more expensive medium price house today for $800,000, but with a lower 3% interest rate as opposed to the 6%, your total interest cost would be about $330,000. That's over $200,000. Less than if you would have bought the less expensive house 15 years ago. And as far as total cost, interest cost plus purchase price, the $590,000 property would have actually cost you $5,000 more. So in summary, you are better off buying the more expensive house now with the lower interest rate than the less expensive house 15 years ago with the higher interest rate. But let's check some different sources. Let's make sure I'm just not making these numbers up. The California Association of Realtors publishes what they call the Housing Affordability Index, which takes into account a 20% down payment, considers prices, interest rates, monthly payments, and well, just a bunch of other stuff. That index is currently around 27%, which is kind of what we've been hovering around for the past couple of years. So despite YouTubers peddling the high prices of today as clickbait, all things considered, homeownership is still, historically speaking, relatively affordable, which makes sense as to why so many people are still buying houses. Now, the least affordable period was actually in 2007, as we probably imagine, when the index hit almost 10%, which is half of where we're at now. So to compare today's market to the bubble market crash of 2007 would just be totally wrong. And unlike back then, when even a rooster could qualify for a mortgage with 0% down, today people actually need to qualify. Lenders now realize that we don't live in la la land, and now they're checking income, expenses, tax returns. They're asking for letters of explanation on that $500 deposit that you made last week. And no, mind your own business, it's not gonna work. But lastly, let's address the criticism that says California and Los Angeles real estate prices are just way too high. Yeah, what rock have you been living under? It's always been that way. Historically, California is expensive. And for some people, that's kind of the point. I mean, people are not like, yeah, I'm gonna go buy a house in Beverly Hills because prices are more affordable there. No, California and Los Angeles real estate is desirable. And for many, yes, It's a status symbol, it's luxury, but for others, it's the weather, the diversity, Mexican food, job opportunities. I mean, according to a bunch of sources, if California were a country by GDP standards, it would be the fifth richest country in the world. That means there is more money in California than the whole United Kingdom. And another theory of what could possibly be happening, imagine the US being a city and each state being a neighborhood. California could very well just be going through one big gentrification, to which people are like, yeah, but everyone's leaving California. Correct. That's what happens with gentrification. People leave. But even celebrities are leaving. Yeah, but many are still keeping their houses in Los Angeles. They're just evading taxes. But let's look at some numbers. Why are people still choosing to own or invest in Los Angeles and California when prices are so high as opposed to, I don't know, more affordable Kentucky? According to the Case-Shiller Housing Index, in the past 20 years, the median price for a home in the US has gone up by about 100%. In Los Angeles, it's gone up by about 200%, almost double what the general US market did. But real estate can also be a very local thing, and it also depends on what neighborhood in Los Angeles you buy. For example, the neighborhood of Venice Beach in the past 20 years has gone up by over 400%. That's almost double what the S&P 500 did during the same period. So yes, California is expensive, but historically, property values in California also tend to appreciate a lot better than many other parts of the country. But in summary, is Los Angeles and California a bubble waiting to burst? I have no idea. One thing is for sure though, historically speaking, nothing is guaranteed with real estate, except prices will go up and prices will go down. So don't worry, the market will eventually crash. When, we just don't know. I mean, I thought prices were gonna go down when Target ran out of toilet paper last year, and no, the opposite happened. Prices skyrocketed. See, I think the crash will come when we least expect it and for reasons we least imagine. But the point of this video is not necessarily to defend California and Los Angeles prices, but rather to shine light on the fact that if we focus purely on prices and the doomsday theories that many of these real estate YouTube channels like to promote because it means more views, if we do that without considering other things like inflation, interest rates, economic growth, wage increases, and a bunch of other stuff, we will have a very miscued and one-sided story upon to which base our decisions. So I have no idea when the market is gonna crash. Your bet is as good as mine, or ask an economist. After all, they predicted the savings and loan crisis in 1990, the Great Recession in 2008, and of course, we all know they saw the pandemic coming from a mile away. But let me know what you guys think, put it in the comments below. And if you like this video, it would mean a lot if you hit that like button. And if you wanna keep getting more Los Angeles and California real estate related videos, make sure to hit that subscribe button. By the way, my name is Daniel Rangel. I'm a real estate agent in Los Angeles. If I can be of any help, it would be an honor. And if you're outside of the Los Angeles area, don't hesitate to reach out. I have a network of real estate agents all over the country that I can connect you with. In the meantime, thanks a bunch for watching and have an awesome day.